So when you started running that shit in Nature Reasoning at A Nova about the obituary, bro, you didn't even know Afro Unu was fucking deceased. Rest in peace. So when you started running that shit in Nature Reasoning at A Nova about the obituary, bro, you didn't even know Afro Unu was fucking deceased. Rest in peace. You didn't even know. The king passed away in 2011, and here we are with Static in 2015 in a NoopooH group that I created that was just getting fresh off the ground. You came in with that hoopla, you went at A Nova over the obituary that you didn't even know about. You said it was wrong for him posting it in the group, in my group.
We have to bring this thing back once again. I keep telling you, as long as you keep lying, we're going to have to keep putting out the facts. All right, so number one, I got to keep repeating that you claim I didn't know nothing about the obituary until Anova put it up in your group, which is a lie. I told you once again, here's the email again that I sent to you and Kepler, right? And what did it say? Forward, Afro Unu obituary, keep safe. Look at the date. Sunday, December the 7th, 2014. So once again, you think you keep telling this lie that it's gonna become true. This is what we talking about, spirit being possession and control. That's a lie. This is the obituary right here. We already know I the one who sent it to y'all and told y'all to keep it safe. So how is it that I'm mad because Anova put the obituary in there and then you tried to say it's because I was mad that he had it first? This is narcissistic games that people like you believe in. All you people want to be first and not gonna never be first. The real first, you're never gonna be that. Cause every time we get into this stuff about who did what first, my, that means all of y'all got a problem with the with Afro Unu position and being who he is. That's the issue. That's the issue right there. And you were jealous and you can't take it that you are who you are, because as a narcissist, one of those things, y'all never feel like you qualify, you never feel like you good enough, and what you do is y'all smoke weed, y'all try to rule other people, make them feel less than themselves, and all the things that you're doing, this is what you like to do. And so here we go again, just to show and prove, I knew exactly what I was doing. I sent you the obituary. You see this? I want you to read this so you can see if you can break from that spirit spell. December 7th, 2014. This the obituary right here. You can see it right here. Saturday, May the 7th, 2011. 12 noon. That was the service. But he passed sunset May 3rd, 2011. All right? So they buried him. Cremated him 4 days later. All right. So now we finna go to another thing. Now we finna get into Anova and what he said in his own words. So let's read what Anova said in the group. See, got official Illuminati. That's your group, right? Now let's look at what he said. Because you full of it and you trying to lie to your audience. I keep telling you that. Look, well, this is May 21st, 2016. See, you've been at this foolishness a long time. More proof that I apologize for my wrongs. Two, Mr. Dead AG was taken up for Anova Noon Ray after all the deception he pulled. Writing the government, threatening them with NoopooH like he was some type of god. LOL, just read the comments and see for yourself. Now let's read this and pay attention to what's being said. All right. True peace to all concerned, and with all due respect to all Noonables are Noon in the positive. This message comes directly from Anova Noon Ray Nupu, Joel Berkeley, the subject of many of your verbal and electronic attacks for quite some time now. All right, now this has been going on since late 2013. So late 2013, if you watch my last video with the email, to January 20, 2015, he had nothing to say. Now watch, now he want to come out and talk. This is what I'm trying to tell y'all. Right, he tell you yourself, he been quiet for some time now. Although I've been silent online, this is for the record so I will not have to address it again, and to clearly state that my silence does not mean tacit agreement to any of your allegations or false claims about me. He must be talking about everybody else, because definitely everything I said about Anova was backed up with his own words and facts. All right, on Sunday, January 18th, CCY 2015, I put up two links to the public memorial information to Johnny Eugene Brown Afro Uno on Facebook in the closed group Nature Reason E Liberation. The first link comes directly from Newark, New Jersey, Perry Funerals Home website, which is the link right here. All right, where they have an online memorial section, including a guest book that anyone could submit their condolences and view of the comments also. This is true. Perry Funeral Home, a public place, was the site of the memorial service ceremony of interment, and here now on Sunday, May 7th, CCY 2011. So we're speaking about an event that took place close to 4 years ago and was thus online for close to 4 years now before most of us knew anything. Noon and his commandment law number 74 states. All right, now he finna try to justify what he's doing. Watch. When a Noonable person dies, he or she must be cremated and the ashes properly disposed of in a suitable location acceptable to all concerned, the same way each time the condition are the same. It continues to state that a family relative may keep the ashes in a private and personal place or deposit them at the roots of a living tree, and the death cycle symbol, the zoop, must be located on the crematory and other place representing the physical dead as on a statue for memorial. As stated, the final disposition of the cremated physical remains of Johnny Eugene Brown Afro Uno is located at Fairmount Crematory in Newark, New Jersey. Again, a public place. He's still trying to justify. Watch. The second link came directly from www.honoreu.com. This, in common terms, is called memorial advertisement, which is usually written by family members or friends. It can be drawn up by assistance from a funeral home or another third party. Honor Your Memorial Products is a Northern Term, Jersey-based company specializing in personalized memorial products. Physical and Virtual also posted the memorial program on their graphics for, as their site clearly states, the memorial programs we create for a family are personalized to match the actual files, creation, picture, and all of it being online. They are by authority of this family. Scroll through their memorial garden section and you yourselves will see the memorial program file that celebrates the life of this great man, created to commemorate his life, even inviting anyone to add a tribute in his memory, obviously authorized by his own family members and all concerned, wife and other, as it states, loving, submitted by the family. Now, the first thing you gotta equal stand is him citing this law about when a Noonable dies, they must be cremated and all of that. It also goes into letting it be known. These people, as far as we know, were not Noonables, because if they were, they would have put it out for other Noonables to know. That didn't happen. Okay? And with my conversation with his wife, totally on a whole different level. All right, so this situation right here, he's trying to use this to justify that he didn't put it out online. So this also debunks the lie that Garu's trying to tell, that Anova had it first. Lies. But watch what Anova says in his own right, on his own writing. This is why it's always good to keep stuff documented. And Anova, when you hear this, remember, this is all your fault, because you decided to still not talk. When we asked you, your kin, the ones you said true care and all this void of lust and all that, when we was begging you to make yourself available for questioning and answering, you did not do so. All right. Now it says Let me now emphatically state this for the record. The information about it being online was shown to me by another NoopooH. I wonder who that was. And not out of malice or negativeness or to gossip, slander, or blaspheme, which is an upgrade or even downgrade of a person's human spirit or reason. So once again, a Nova tells you somebody else gave it to him. So why are you lying, saying that a Nova had it first? Lies. The same way you just lied and said, I didn't know after Uno was passed. That's a lie. Noosa knew first. No, he didn't know first. We knew first because Royal told me and a Noop personally. Then we told Noosa and the word spread around. Then Noosa found the obituary in 2014. Then a Noop found it like a day or so later. We got it. And then I sent it to the rest of y'all because Noosa didn't want to let nobody else know about it. Another problem that we're having because y'all like to play hide and seek and go get it and blame Tarnoon for all things that went wrong when all of y'all were being deceptive for your own reasons because all of y'all was jealous and you was feeling threatened by me for whatever reason it was. I still don't get it. All right. Not out of malice or negativeness or to gossip, slander, or blaspheme, which is an upgrade or even downgrade of a person, human spirit, or reason. But because some others had this public information for months now, right? He talking about us, because we the only ones that had it. And it wasn't even that long, because this is January. We got the obituary in December 2014. So it wasn't that long. Alright? And we're asking others not to reveal it. That's he talking about me. Right? And asking others not to reveal it, right? Look. Hold on. Wrong. Right here. What did it say? I said keep safe. That's that he's speaking about me indirectly. Still being a coward. We in the same group. He's still being a coward. Right? Now, and we're asking others not to reveal it. However, those who want to use information, whether correct or incorrect, as a trump card to play against others, that's you, they debate and argument with, have been stopped by this action. Absolutely not. When posted those links, I did not put any negative comment or caption. That is true. And I didn't assume that the persons who see it are not intelligent enough to understand it, just cut and pasted the link so anyone concerned could see it. Now, the problem with this logic, sir, is that Garu had Nawapians in the group too. So this was not an all NoopooH group. That was the first mistake. So stop acting as if you knew everybody in there could be trustworthy because it was Noopoohs in there. Ethereum was in there. He was a Nawapian. Barry Blast was in there. It's mad people who were Nawapians who were using Noon. Everything was cool in the game before I came. This is why Garu was mad in this first clip when he said that me and Anova came in his group with the hoopla, and that's when everything went haywire. And what happened was, when I left the group, everything followed with me. The same thing that happened in Central Solution when Andrew had all of us was in the group. In the Central Solution, they started that whole crap about thinking they the number one ruler, they the number one nigga. As soon as I left, everybody left too. As soon as we went and got into a group that the Ken Nair built the group, the Noon versus Wu Nawa, all of that, everybody came there for years. We had the attention of the internet between us and Chuck's group. That's where it was. So that's what's wrong with your boy. That's what's wrong with Mr. Butthurt. He's mad because all the people left his group because he wanted to be worshipped. That's why he keep talking about my group. My group. My group. No, it's not. That's possession. You want to possess other people. Alright, so that's what happened. They just snatched the rug from under you and you can't get over that. All right? That's your problem, narcissist. All right? He said, and I just cut and pasted the link so anyone concerned can see it, read and interpret it, and further reason it all out for themselves. I am not trying to control the flow of public information. I did not and do not have to filter or interpret that public information for others because their own intelligence and reason will guide them. I chose to do what I did out of true care to all concerned, and my motives were positive and honorable, not in bad taste, nor does it show disrespect or disloyalty to Noonables or Noon, of which I am one. Lies. All right? Tell the truth. You posted that because you obviously had a conversation with Garu, because Garu had it before you. But he didn't want to be the one to post the link. See, he's real good at setting people up to take the fall for him. Because there's no way out of nowhere. You've been quiet all this time. You know where the obituary came from because you're hinting at me in the whole time. Same way Garu wants to lie that I didn't have it to give you credit. That's how he told on you. So, Negro, you did put it out to try to spite me, but you really disrespected Afro Uno by doing that because we refused to put his information out for months until Jay Reese and them got a hold of it. So, we was respecting the family. You put it out where there was a mixture of Noonables and Dr. York followers who stole Afro Uno's books and life. And you still put it out there knowing this because by this time, we have been raising hell about something wasn't clean with York and Afro Uno's information. So you can't claim y'all didn't know. All right? Afro Uno's family or any other negative perception anyone else can create. Furthermore, it was not prompted by negative nature. That's a lie. And it was definitely not immoral or unlawful. Number one, it was egotistical. All right, ain't nobody got to talk about immoral, because immoral is dealing with how people are raised and their beliefs and how they deal with humans and certain things like that. Immoral can deal more with more so sexual things or crimes to that's beyond what people usually used to. We're not talking about stealing a couple of dollars. And immoral goes into degradation and filthiness. So you trying to throw this word in here to cover for you. It wasn't unlawful as far as the United States is concerned, because that's what you trying to hide behind. But it was unlawful in the form of in nature's concern, in the sense of it's kind of similar to having the doctor patient what is that called? The doctor patient I can't think of it. It was an agreement where the doctor confidentiality. That's what it is. And even though I'm using this in another context, the point was all of us knew not to put it out because Afro Uno's people's names is on there, and we wanted to respect it because we knew from looking at it that if he wanted it known, or his wife wanted it known, they would have made it known to some kind of form. Where it would have been known out there, some kind of form. So you doing that was just so what Garu is doing right now is praising you for something you know you shouldn't have done too, and also to give you fake credit, and you also didn't take the opportunity to apologize, or at least even in the group say, yo, I'm the one that, you know, Tanu making all this noise about. Is not what he's saying is not wrong, because you never debunked nothing I said. Anything I put out was correct. But that's why I said in the group, and I said this multiple times, because I'm pretty sure God was going to go after this video and look at all that and try to pull it up, because he never showed y'all what I was saying in the group. But this is what it all come down to, that you buck dance from behind the scenes off Facebook to coming on Facebook in this group. And then you want to say, the first thing you say after all of the drama that's been going on, you want to talk about Afro Uno's obituary. Now you want to defend it because I was getting at you in the group and you was being a coward. I never threatened you. All I said was be the right Ken and do the right thing. But just like Garu, your spirit won't let you live either. It won't let you go. All right. Almighty Nature, he said, I do not need permission or authorization from anyone. There we go again. Ego. There you go. They think they're above a reproach. Almighty Nature has the ability to do anything possible by whomever it chooses, by whatever means, desired, or necessary. That was already done. See, once again, you sound like a Christian. You sound like a religionist. Only God can choose to do what God does. God is almighty. God can use whoever he will. That's just like Pastor Nova. This is why I call you that, Mr. Religionist. This is why you're trying to use NoopooH or Nature as using you to do something that I already done. I already sent the stuff out. So what are you talking about? Nature chose you to do something. You ain't do nothing but put something out after the fact to get fake glory from it. All right? Here we go again. Whoever it chooses, and it wasn't you, and by whatever means, desired, or necessary, it wasn't you. As nine ether NoopooH, its positive forces pushing and pull the smart circle of order upwards. So I'm just doing my best and letting NoopooH do the rest, as all should. That right there had nothing to do with what you just said. Because doing your best, you would have came out and accepted responsibility and not let me get scapegoated and jumped on by 98% of these Noonaboos and the Wapins for something you could have stopped. That's your fault. Noon states, when a Noonaboo person passes away, that death must be strictly reported to the authorities for the official records, which must be efficiently kept in chronological and alphabetical order, and the same carefulness and accurateness must be exercised in the court and recorded birth records. Birth and also death records must be carefully guarded. Of course, the cause of person's death must be on paper, page, age, gender, date, cremated, by whom, etc. Because once a body is cremated, it is impossible to identify him or her anymore in any way, and it is a calamity to look for a missing person whose body has been incinerated to the point of complete disintegration and records lost or non-existent. Therefore, all demised persons must be definitely identified and the proper records on them kept correctly at all times by the authorities that be. Let it be remembered, always let it be known. So are you telling me that Garu's group is the authorities? Are you telling me Garu's group is the place of death where the records are kept? Because that makes no sense for you to be quoting that. Because that's what it sounds like. You trying to make it sound like you are part of the those who facilitate funeral arrangements. But I just could have swore, we just read up above, that the link to the obituary came from the people that did all that. So why are you repeating something that we already know took place? It's called you trying to justify it. That's what you're trying to do. All right? You're trying to justify and clean up your foolishness. All right? For those who lack comprehension and who would misconstrue the correct information above, this refers to carefully guarding the actual birth and death certificate as governmental and societal paper records by the authorities of a true cultural society, not a general public information by the person birth or death on the world wide web. So why did you put it on the web, bro? You just went against everything you just said. So why did you put it in a group then? Because you're trying to clean up and justify what you just did. Read that again. You just said, this refers to carefully guarding your actual birth and death certificates, governmental and societal paperwork by the authorities of a true cultural society. So once again, I ask you again, is Garu's group true cultural society? And who's guarding the death certificate? Is it you? I'm just trying to understand. This is why you have to investigate, ask the right questions, as my wife say. You always got to ask the right questions. Here we go. Obituaries, news articles that report the recent death of a person, typically along with an account of the person's life information about the upcoming funeral, like memorial information, are even commonly posted as public record in most, if not all, local newspapers. Again, this is not a newspaper. And Afrunu had passed at least about 4 years ago. So what are you doing? Let's continue. I'm not angry with anyone, past or present, and I am in true peace with all. We know this is a lie. I would be mad if I was you. What happened in the past with a few other Nooniboos, speaking of me, and the rest, the Noon Project needed to happen. Really? And I am peace at with my beloved wife and Nooniboo kin in general. No, that's all lies. Holding no grudges, that's a lie, because you would have been came out by now. And having no regrets, lies. Everyone is entitled to their opinion. This is not an opinion. Everything I put out was facts. However, there will be no kumbaya and holding hands together in the future for me and birds of another feather. So that means you got a problem. You just said you have no problem and you at peace with everybody. But then you say it won't be no kumbaya. Kumbaya is a song or title that people sing when they want to come together in unison. They always say, kumbaya, my Lord, and they hold hands and sing this song, kumbaya. See how you a liar? You telling lies, but you think that no one sees you. All right? What else it says? Birds of another feather who have proven themselves to be lovers of drama and chaos and who have continued to use Noon to attack others. The books says use the information to determine right from wrong, and the book says Armageddon time. So guess what? It's no attacking. We're not attacking. We are reacting because of the lies that York has done. All right? I am not competing or debating because you would lose. That's why you ain't came out. You would lose in any form or venue with anyone about who has more knowledge or understanding or wisdom. This ain't about that. This is about your activities, as Mr. Garutz likes to talk. Let's talk about that, right? You writing the government thinking you had some country behind you shows that you got mental problems. It is what it is. Who has more knowledge and understanding was? It is what it is. Intelligence recognizes intelligence. And the facts are the facts. Again, that has nothing to do. What they got to do with what we're talking about here. Either we're about the truth, you're not, or we want more lies. That's what you allowed to happen. You didn't want the truth to come out, and therefore you refused to come out. So everybody had to guess or go off what I was saying and other people, and it just got misconstrued, because the only one who could have stopped this was you. And you refused. It's 2014. It's 2021, almost 7 years later, and you still with the games. Either we about the truth or we want lies. Either we will continue to look to others for the answers to settle the issues that come up every day, or we be still and watch while we reason things out individually and collectively. Do something positive and stop self-righteously focusing on your negative interpretation of someone else's life. You should be telling Garu that. That's not what Noon teaches. Noon clearly states that if it's indeed time for each and every person to what? Stand up on their own feet in marriage. You ain't did that. Good or bad, but all I have heard in the last few months is blame, 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 because it's true. And no personal accountability. That's you. Or responsibility. That's you. Go back and look what you're saying. And no personal accountability or responsibility for one's own judgments. That's you. I am being judged for my individual actions. You damn right, because the book tells you to do so. Let me pull that up real quick. All right, so look right here. It says in Law 46 in Book 2, scapegoatism is a practice of barbarianism, and it is forbidden now that the moon cycle is over. The same way each time that conditions are the same. Now that the moon cycle has run its course, it is time for each and every person to stand on his or her own merits and be counted and judged by Almighty Nature in its balancing of powers and persons and things. Scapegoatism is an affront to justice and fair play, and therefore it cannot stand and prevail in the time of justice. The guilty can no longer hide behind and stigmatize the innocent, because the time for putting blame on the innocent and getting away with it is over. Meaning the use of scapegoatism will now cause negative backlashes on the guilty. The guilty persons are the enemies of the Ethiopian race and those who transgress the laws of nature after learning what they are or refuse to learn and practice law thereof and after having access to them, be a member well. So that's what's taking place. You was using, allowing me to be scapegoated. You didn't scapegoat me. Let me be clear. But I became scapegoated by Garu and everybody else who didn't want me to keep telling you the answer up for what you had done dealing with the government and all of that stuff. That was the reason. And guess what? When they did that, when Garu stood up for you and all these people refused to hold you accountable, guess what they was doing? They was committing forgiveness and mercy as religious doctrines or anti-justice dogmas indeed forbidden in Noom society, true cult society, the same way each time the conditions are the same. Like the writer himself, everyone likes to be forgiven or be given mercy for errors and also wrongness committed. Even Afro-Unu said that. But that was the moon cycle. Moreover, according to the laws of nature, forgiveness and mercy do not mean that punishment for the guilty was destroyed or eliminated by simply delayed or postponed to a later date or time, like Armageddon, to be accounted for by the guilty one or what? His family, descendants, or kind. The Libra cycle of new order, which is beginning now, means balance and justice, also security for the innocent. And the Libra cycle is already begun, is deliberation via NoopooH. Let it be remembered, always let it be known. Now this is Garu. See, it goes into other stuff. Lying and cheating are iniquities despised and chastised the same way each time the conditions are the same. It is true that some lies are harmless and even beneficial, but sometimes it's hard to distinguish between a lie that is more harmful than helpful and one that is more helpful than harmful. So the best thing to do is avoid lying, because after a while, lying becomes a bad habit. Anyway, a bad habit. Adhere to the old adage, honesty is the best policy, and live with it. That's what you need to do. You need to be honest and come out and let people know what it is. Because I've been suffering because of your inability to be able to come out and get in front of this thing and say I was wrong for what I did. So that means all this time, not only did you not want to stand up for what you've done, because you didn't stand up on your own merits, even when you came out doing this apology, whatever this is, you still didn't stand on your own merits. And you didn't give a damn about me, because you watched me for years stand on what I've been saying since the beginning, that it was a wrong. And the book say, report a crime. That's what I did. You don't think what you did was a crime? I don't understand that. You don't think that if the government took what you said seriously, that that wouldn't be considered a crime to the government as well? They would have considered you a homegrown terrorist. That's what they call that, paper terrorism. That's what you were doing. So don't tell me I'm wrong for trying to help you before it got worse than it was. All right, so let's continue. And no personal accountability or responsibility for one's own actions and choices, and so many blatant false accusations and judgment. That's a lie. Everything I accuse you of, I proved it. All right? I'm being judged for my individual actions. This is what the nature book said. You will be judged by nature and its punishing powers. We are only judging you verbally. Whatever nature gonna do to you, that's because you refuse to correct something that could have been way worse had the government reacted to that paperwork. So not only did nature not allow them to come and get you for that foolishness you wrote, but you had a chance to stop what was going on in my situation, but you felt it was necessary because you felt you was innocent. But you knew you was wrong, and you said it up here when we read it. You knew you made some wrong actions, but you didn't come out and deal with it in the public. Why? Because you did it in the public. You didn't do something behind the scenes. You took a document and you put it in the public domain. Once you put it out there, it's known. And I'm gonna show more proof of that after this. So nobody's taking something we heard in private and then went into the public with it and then trying to scapegoat you or play down your character. No, you did something that was highly dangerous. And many people do this all the time around the world. The sovereign citizens, certain people that follow the Moorish information, they write stuff all the time. You aware of this? All right, you are being judged for your individual actions. All of you are doing. Judgment time, and no one needs others to point the finger at them and others. That's a lie. Who told you that? Like they deserve verbal and virtual abuse. It's not a. It's only abuse to you because you don't want to come out. You only thinking it's abuse, but what you think I went through? You was able to hide for years. You can't even talk about abuse. Only one person was saying something towards you, me. And because of that, look what then happened. So what are you talking about? There's no verbal abuse. I the one who suffered verbal abuse. You gotta be kidding me with this foolishness you wrote. Alright, many of the accusers' false claims against me are for the same types of act they have done or continue to do, like the violation of others' privacy, taping phone conversations without permission. And now he's speaking of conversation I done had. But what about you? Who told you to write the government? We didn't all agree to that. And you know what makes it ridiculous you putting that in there? Because you wrote the documents, more than one, and you put all Noonie Boos in that document. Nobody gave you permission to do that. So you got the nerve, you freaking hypocrite. You being a hypocrite right here. Private information via email, video files, etc. Illegal and unlawful activities, violation of the laws of nature. First of all, what's illegal? So you use the word illegal, now you're talking about the Caucasian laws. So you're trying to mix it all in. What you did was transgress the laws of nature because you wanted to be Afro Unu and you was trying to be like that on low key. So who's the liar? You are. Libel, slander, and blasphemy, that's all you. Until you can prove anything I ever said concerning you was a lie, I take back everything I said. If you can show me where anything I said about you dealing with the government, saying you was Jesus, and all of this crap, I stop being a Noonable. If you can show me where you never said any of those things concerning you think you was going to undo what Afro Unu did, you thought Afro Unu was Dr. York, and all of this stuff. If anything I ever put out on you was a lie, I stopped being a Noonable. Let's go. He said, every negative deed and act, negative works and words and works eventually comes to light. Of course, yours been came to light. What are you talking about? I am not perfect. I have made many mistakes. The only mistake you made was not taking responsibility that we care about, that implicated all other Noonie Boos in your personal issue because you didn't want to pay your mortgage. You got tired of paying rent and mortgage. And you put all of us in danger because you didn't want to pay. Now tell me, is that selfish? Yes, it is. You put all of us in your crap. That's the root of all of this. All right? I have made many mistakes. I have been wrong on many occasions. Yes, you was. The same way when we all sat there in front and on the floor in your house, you was writing this document to the bank. Your wife did not know you was not gonna pay the rent and you wasn't paying the rent for months. Your woman looked crazy when you told everybody and she found it out at the same time. I bust out in tears because she was hurt. I'm like, what? You gotta be kidding me. You ain't honest, you a liar. Who does that? This woman been with you for all these years. Got rid of her ID. Trying to act like y'all sovereign in Texas. And you can't go nowhere without no ID. You did that for years. Your wife gave up all of her credentials, living at home with a beautiful garden and all that stuff. But the whole thing was you was not in your own country. And y'all in there, she's following you. You can't be serious. You did many wrongs. And that was one of them. Who stays? So this woman was depending on you. She didn't work. She did hair every now and then. Sold every now and then. Which brings me to my other point. The reason that me and Ray Noon Ray, rest in peace, got into it about my shirt that I had specially made when I was sending this picture to Miss Newpool's niece and he was going back and forth about the shirt, and that the shirt wasn't all the way up to par. Y'all wasn't there for the argument. He was like, yo, the shirt was, you know, it got wrinkles and stuff in it. And I was like, Ray, no Ray, I got the shirt right here. I can always easily iron it and take, which I did. I ironed the shirt, took a picture of it, then sent it. But he was so adamant about me not sending no pictures. It wasn't just that picture. And then you guess what he said? After all that arguing, we went back about my creativity, our creativity, or getting the symbols put on our shirts to show up for your wedding. He said, man, all I just wanted was some symbols on my clothes. I'm mad I ain't got no clothes. If I'm lying, I'm dying. So guess what that means? He was upset because he didn't have no clothes with the symbols on it. But guess whose problem that could have been solved by? You and your wife. Why? Because your wife sews. And you sitting here posing in your Facebook pictures with NoopooH symbols. You even got a video with you rapping with the NoopooH symbol, like on a black, like an eight ball with the little magic eight ball, which you could shake it and it give you answers. You had with the seal of Almighty Nature on a toy, but Ray Noon Ray didn't have one shirt with the symbols on it, and your wife could have been done that. I even told you before, if I knew your wife was sewing, then we could have been sending you money for her to have, she can sew stuff for us. So Ray Noon Ray was mad because guess what? His so-called closest kin, Ray Noon Ray, who couldn't even drive, who took 3-4 buses, took over an hour to get to your house to sit with you, and that man, all he wanted was a couple of symbols on his shirt. And he had to pay you to cut his hair. You know he didn't like that, but because he loved you, he didn't say nothing. That man always used to say, I always gotta travel way from my house to your house to see Kinoo. I never said nothing about it because that was my place. But I was there listening to all of the things you was doing, and you still was eating meat and you smoked weed. But this is the thing I'm talking about. I don't care about none of these things, but because I gotta still deal with this rogue Negro who's using you once again, you gotta understand, you refusing to take initiative, take responsibility. He's using what he knows you're not gonna stand up like a man. That's what he's showing, that he's saying that Anova's not a man, because he won't stand up and tell me to stop. The same way Kepler came in and said, yo, take my video down, I didn't give you permission, he took it down. Now, I don't think you're a weakling. I think you're very intelligent. I think you're a stand-up guy for the most part. Just in this case right here, you flunked with flying colors. I'm telling you, this is what Garu is looking at. He's looking at you not gonna be a man and stand up. We talking about being moral. Let's talk about morals. Morals deal with codes, ethics, guy codes. What a guy code at for that? What type of guy code that you leave another can out there hanging because you did something and somebody checked you for it? This is the proof why we can't come together. Every time we check one another, this is what takes place. Resistance. And eventually a fallout. Because the spirit in you is so filthy that any type of truth confronting the programmer and controller, the controller always destroys the unity. That's how I know none of y'all are ready. Like people say, you think y'all just gonna wake up one day, be in Africa sipping on margaritas outside of coconuts, hollering true peace and birds flying around with an N on their back? The pygmy gods gonna be dancing around at the equator at every ninth day of the month. You just go down there to Lake Victoria and hold hands and say I'm the high priest of noon and throw turpentine and soap in the water, and they just gonna bubble up and they just gonna come out and speak to you in a universal language, and then y'all can go back to what you was doing? All y'all on drugs. 6 ether. Delusion. Alright? Now he gonna say here, I'm not perfect, I have made many mistakes. I have been wrong on many occasions. I've been rushed to judgments on many subjects. Yes, you have. But I'm growing every day in the positive. No, you're not. Because you would have came up when you came out. You would have started with this here totally different. I am still innocent. That's a lie. And you got it in all caps, too. That's a damn lie. What the hell? And no one can put blame off on scapegoat for me for causing them pain and suffering. That's another lie. Because this is directly because of you. Everybody can see that. This only would work if it was no evidence. It'd be my word against yours. But guess what? It's not my word against yours. It's me who was there. I was had a front row seat. I got all the receipts. And judging by what you wrote here, it showed that you still was insane. Because you believe you was innocent. The same way when you lost your house and walked out of the courtroom, Raylan Ray, rest in peace, and your wife, you told them, NoopooH has forsaken me. Said your wife eyes look crazy. Raylan Ray said, what the hell in his head? And you walked off down the street because you thought your great glorious day was gonna happen in court. You thought you was gonna walk out of there doing your thing. Say you went in there with your little hat on, like you was sovereign, and the judge told you to take it off. And guess what? You took it off. Everything you thought, all the conversation we had up to date, before you was going to the court like you was Jesus that was going in front of Pontius Pilate. Pastor Nova, you lost. I told you was insane. You went in there and flunked. And that's a shame because you are a brilliant black man. Brilliant. But you allowed yourself to be compromised. You let your wife down, not only in front of a kin, but in front of a stranger and a bunch of strangers in the courtroom who didn't understand nothing else, but you gonna pay this mortgage or you finna get up out of here. And you've been past the time for that because Chase Bank gave you mad chances to pay, even though they said the guy you got the house from was illegal on what he was doing. They still said because you was paying on time, perfect timing, they was working with you. You could have still kept your house. All the years you and your wife put into that house, building the backyard, a perfect garden, you threw all that away. Spirit being foolishness. Right? For causing them pain and suffering, you caused your wife pain and suffering. Or for being disloyal to Nunaboos, you was disloyal in the sense that you did something that the people who was around you when you was writing it, because I didn't come until after that, they didn't have enough sense to know that what they was doing was dangerous. So you was not disloyal, you was being, what's the word I'm looking for? You was being irresponsible, dangerously irresponsible. Because the same way when you was sending all that paperwork to Chase Bank, they sent some dudes sitting out your house, staking your house, watching you. You told me that. I think they came there one time when we was there. And they was from Chase Bank watching your house. Soon as they sent the letter back that they was finna get you out of there, and they sent you that paperwork to go to court, that's when they started showing up staking out your house. Your wife was shook because she didn't know what they was gonna do. Again, nothing in Noon told you to do that. All right? Nor NoopooH Noon and his laws. That's a lie. Because you scapegoated NoopooH by saying NoopooH, it was NoopooH's fault that you lost your house. That's what you told Raylan Ray. Because he called me soon as y'all came out of the courtroom. You were so distressed and distraught and let down. You left Raylan Ray with your wife to walk down the street because you lost in the court. And you didn't have to do that. Completely avoidable. All right, these are the demonic ramblings a person refused to take personal responsibility for their own selves and lives, mental, spiritual, and physical. Again, you're talking about yourself. That's the funny thing about negative spirit beings. When they talk about others, they speaking in reverse. You the only one who didn't take responsibility. You didn't want to take responsibility for paying your mortgage. And guess what? You went to court and lost. Is that responsibility? Because I understand that when you get an apartment or you rent a room or you rent a car and you paying and you leasing something, you pay and you keep it. If you fall delinquent, guess what? They take it from you. But being responsible is able to meet those demands every month, every week, bi-weekly, or however it is, every couple of months. That's called being responsible in reality in the Caucasian system. Matter of fact, anywhere there's some type of currency or an exchange or some type of trade in an agreement, you the one who didn't take responsibility. And you end up losing a house and end up getting another house you had to pay more on. And then you tried to justify it after the blowout and say, you know, NoopooH was working with us because, you know, the house we got, guess what, Ken? It was built in 1962. What the hell that got to do with anything? You know, 1 plus 9 plus 6 plus 2 equals 9. I'm like, yo, you done lost your mind. You just had a house where the rent was cheaper, lost that, all the work you had, to pay for another house to rent. And you said all that balanced out because it was built in 1962? Yo, I don't know why. If I was, man, your wife should have slapped the fire out your beard because of how stupid you sounded when you told us that. All of us would say, yo, this dude done lost his damn mind, because that's exactly what you did. But I'm going to continue on. Soon I will completely delete all my online accounts. That's a lie, because it's still up. And fully become private as the first begotten of the mental dead was. That was not Afro-Uno. Once again, you talking about York. Nowhere in the nature books or the BIAE or the nine ball refers to Afro-Uno or Aminu Rakapatar as the first begotten of the mental dead. This religious crap is amazingly ignorant. Alright? They in groups control. Best of my knowledge, these are the demonic ramblings. They in groups controlled by one or more dominant persons. Once again, he's talking about the Noon group. But you was in the group of a dominant person that's being controlling. Look at him now. And I'm sure you watching these videos, you mean to tell me that Garu is positive? You gotta be kidding me. Persons are more religious in their attitudes and dealing with others than any religious and gold standard. That's a lie. How the hell can you say what we've been doing, fighting in the name of NoopooH Noon against the Wyvians, followers of a pedophile, six ether worshiper, liar, religionist? That's the biggest religionist that me and you both know. York did something that most people don't do in their life. This dude made three cults, religion, Islam, and Christianity, and then threw some pantheism in there, wore all these hats, say he was God, he was the son of God, he was Inky, then he was the son of Inky, he was the son, the great-grandson of the Most High. There ain't nobody more worse than that. And you comparing us to that? You really out your mind. Soon I will complete, we go post, blah, blah, blah. This is the focus on my household, my family. You almost lost your household. You lucky your woman didn't leave you after that. Because she was homeless. She left her family to be with you. Gave up her ID and all of that stuff. You think her folks didn't think she was a nut job? Man, you gotta be kidding me. And those who I flock with, I control myself and have no obligation to try to control anyone else. But that's all you was doing in the WhatsApp chats. You know I can bring that up just to prove that's a lie too. So I don't know why you think I won't come back and check you. Nobody else will. My loyalty is those who truly have true care for all, void of lust, void of power struggling, lies, void of slander, lies, void of anger, lies, void of blaming spirits of human, lies. You blame NoopooH for losing your house. What do you call that? You went above blaming spirits and humans. You blame the parent powers of all of the universes. You can't get more worse than that. Void of demonic deceptions, lies, and I'm not saying I'm infallible. You just said that. You basically saying you around people that don't do none of this power, struggling, void. That's a lie. This is where all the things that plague human beings right now. Lust, power, struggling, slander, anger, blaming, spirits, all of that stuff. The only ones who are blameless is Sound Right Reason. NoopooH is the blamer. NoopooH creates situations for you to get blamed. It created the situation for you. You blame the Caucasian for and using all the laws of the land and the birth certificate. Don't make me go get the documents, bro. You got the documents that blame the Caucasian for the reason why you have to pay mortgage and rent. I can go show you where you blame them for that. That's why you refuse to pay. And you end up losing your house. So don't talk about you not blaming. Your whole document to Chase Bank and to the U.S. government and the U.S. Treasury was doing just that. And you was using the nature books to say so. I'm not saying I'm infallible or beyond question. I'm saying lynch mobs with torches and pitchforks, threatening violence, verbal, physical, or virtual has no place in the life of Inunabu. If you all claim Afro Uno was private, keep his wife, the love of his life, family and friends, kin, relatives in his circle tight, not seeking the limelight. And as many also claim in the face of a flamboyant imposter.
All right, what was that? Who plagiarized his life and writing, yet he played the background and kept quiet. Then let me be free to be private and stop antagonizing and aggressing against me and my family. Number one, I've never said nothing bad about Inova, all right? Me or my wife. My wife, up to maybe 2018, she was hitting your wife up every couple of months. So let's stop with the foolishness. I would never say nothing bad about Inova. Unless I heard her say something bad about me or mine. But outside of that, I've always had nothing but lovely things to say about her. So let's start adding that into it, because now you're lying again. And stop antagonizing and aggressing against me and my family. Acknowledge my public silence as a powerful remedy we all can learn from Afro Uno himself. Nobody's acknowledging anything except you a coward. Afro Uno stayed quiet because he knew that he was gonna end up going up against a cult, and York would have had that man killed, especially they was in the same damn town. So we ain't finna play them games. And plus he knew how spiritually possessed black people was on top of that. So why would he go out there doing what everybody else was doing? And that's another reason why you try to lay low as being silent too. Cause you really think you the next Afro Uno and you not. All right? Our noble model to follow in the positive. There's got to be more to all of this, but personally, I am sick and tired of all these online games. Ain't nobody playing no games but you. With fools who want to dictate others what they should know and not know. That's all you in the Nun Project group. I got all the proof. Keep the private and the public and let me be. P.S. Keep your online reply to yourself. I'll not be answering you back. Good. But guess what? I'm answering back because you still refuse. And I'm going to see if you say that to Garu. You ain't going to say nothing. Now, if you answer him back, I'm definitely going to let the dogs loose. I'm letting you know right now. So if you come out and tell Garu anything, I hope there's an apology attached to that. True in the cause of peace and wartime.
Thank you.
Say hi to the camera. This is my first video. Turn over. True peace. Ray New Ray.
Woo! All right.
And me! Another New Ray. NoopooH. Oh yeah, we're about to do this. We're about to go to Home Depot. Not Home Depot.
Yes.
I wish we was going to Home Depot to build something. To buy something to build. We'll be going to Staples and the Office Max.
I have wants and desire just like you. So move on aside, cause I'm coming through.
Okay, so we are in Staples. We're documenting this crap. And how Southworth has a monopoly on the whole paper industry. In the three locations we've been to Walmart, we've been to Staples, which is this is, and we've been to FedEx Kinko's. And all of them have this Southworth paper that ain't worth nothing.
This is a message to y'all. Together we stand.
Some old bullshit. Yeah.
We know him. We witnessed them.
What I'm gonna talk
that signature
about.
Page together.
Mm-hmm.
And just like you said.
Affect you. Yes. Because we're documenting this. In the positive, we want to let it be known that we want to affect in the positive every single person of the Ethiopian race. Although they don't know that they're pitch novas, they still are black new stars. See, that's the thing. Acceptance is not what makes you a black new star. By race, that's what we are by nature. By race, all of our surname is NoopooH. But the persons that learn, accept, and practice positive nature knowledge, they gain the right to take it on as an official, you know, surname. So. Just beautiful, because eventually what's going to happen is the trickle effect, the ripple effect is going to be throughout the whole world. As we start identifying with our true culture and start building true culture, people even like him, we'll be able to come back to him. Look, we, you remember us?
That boy too wide is something else.
You know, we printed that particular document. This is what it is. And imagine his face. When he realized the gravity of what he helped us do. That's powerful.
I've been in a print shop kind of like that before. I've worked at Kinoo before.
Mm-hmm.
And I know there's a mandate that you're not supposed to save a document for a customer that's not being printed. But you can't tell me that they looked at that screen and both of them was like, wait a minute, this is something altogether different.
I think they looked at the screen and they said, you know, I think they said like, what is this? You know, they had a kind of look on their face, and it's deep because she could have did all the work herself.
Yeah.
She chose to call him to answer the question of the paper issue. And then when he was helping, you know, he was able to give a more validity to the whole event because two witnesses.
Yeah, two witnesses.
To it. And his name is Messiah? Dude. Because two witnesses.
Yeah, two witnesses.
To it. And his name is Messiah? And his name is Messiah? Dude. Signing of the bond signature page. And the smash circle of water is looking lovely. Looking lovely.
There it is. And the bond, the official first bond right there.
The bond is going to do what it do.
I wish I was in a calculated day.
Yes. Noon Ethiopian year 049 as the principal, author, inscriber, physical. Because we know spirit, mental authors of this liberation bond is the liberated power 90 to NoopooH, of which we are its posterity. So we have four copies. And with each of them, the principals and contributing beneficiaries, they will have a copy, and then the original one that we send to the U.S. Department of Treasury for their notification, that will be sent. So each one of us will have a copy.
Oh, okay.
You know, so that's why we have four.
Have a copy, but yeah, those are the ones y'all gonna send.
Grammatical way. And it doesn't matter that, you know, you might run over the line.